सुवृंदावन मथुरा जय श्री महापुर नवदीप धाम की, जय श्री जगन्नाथ पुरी धाम की, जय गंगा देवी जमुना देवी की, जय भक्ति देवी की, जय श्रीमद तुलसी महाराण की, जय श्री हरिनाम संकीर्तन की, जय श्री प्रभुपाद ट्रांसजेंडर बुक डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन की, जय श्री गौर निताय की, जय श्री कृष्ण बलराम की, जय श्री राधा श्याम सुंदर दर्शक देवी की, जय ग्रंथराज श्रीमद्भागवतम की, जय समवेत भक्त वृंद की, निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज, ऑल ग्लोरीज टू असेंबल्ड डिवोटीज, ऑल ग्लोरीज ऑलवेज श्री गुरु एंड गौरंग, जय श्री प्रभुपाद। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरये। नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवते उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवतिनैश्चिके मूकं गृदिवाचालं पङ्गुलङ्घयते गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे श्रीगुरुं दीनधारणं श्रीपरमानन्दमाधवम्। So today we are reading from Srimad Bhagavatam, 7th canto, 5th chapter, text 14. Yatha brahmyati ayo brahman swayam akarsa sannidho तथा मे भिद्यते चेतस चक्रपाणिर्यदृच्छया यथा भ्रम्यति अयो ब्रह्मन् स्वयं आकर्ष सन्निधो तथा मे भिद्यते चेतस चक्रपाणिर्यदृच्छया यथा भ्रम्यति अयो ब्रह्मन् स्वयं आकर्षसन्निधौ तथा मे विद्यते चेत चक्रपाणिर्यदृच्छया। यथा ब्रह्मते अयो ब्रह्म स्वयं आकर्षसन्निधो तथा मे भिद्यते चेत चक्रपाणिर्यदृच्छया। यथा ब्रह्मते अयो ब्रह्म स्वयं आकर्षसन्निधो तथा मे भिद्यते चेत चक्रपाणिर्यदृच्छया। यथा ब्रह्मति अयो ब्रह्म स्वयं आकर्षसन्निधो तथा मे भिद्यते चेत चक्रपाणिर्यदृच्छया। माताजी, यथा ब्रह्मति अयो ब्रह्म स्वयं आकर्षसन्निधो तथा मे भिद्यते चेत चक्रपाणिर्यदृच्छया। यथा जस्ट एज ब्रह्मति मूव्स अयः आयरन ब्रह्मन ओ ब्राह्मणस स्वयं इट्सेल्फ आकर्ष ऑफ ए मैग्नेट सन्निधो इन द प्रॉक्सिमिटी तथा सिमिलरली मैं माय भिद्यते इज चेंज चेतः कॉन्शसनेस चक्रपाणे ऑफ लॉर्ड विष्णु हु हैज ए डिस्क इन हिज हैंड यदृच्छया सिंपली बाय द विल ट्रांसलेशन एंड परपर्ट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस एसी भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद। ट्रांसलेशन ओ ब्राह्मणस टीचर्स As iron attracted by a magnetic stone moves automatically towards the magnet, my consciousness, having been changed by his will, is attracted by Lord Vishnu, who carries a disc in his hand. Thus, I have no independence. Purpose. For iron to be attracted by a magnet is natural. Similarly, for all living entities to be attracted towards Krishna is natural. And therefore, the Lord's real name is Krishna, meaning he who attracts everyone and everything. The typical example of such attraction are found in Vrindavan, where everything and everyone is attracted by Krishna. The elderly persons like Nanda Maharaj and Yashoda Devi, the friends like Sudama, and the other cowherd boys, the gopis like Srimati Radharani and her associates, and even the birds, beasts, cows, and calves are attracted. The flowers and fruits in the gardens are attracted. The waves of the Yamuna are attracted. And the land, sky, trees, plants, animals and all other living beings are attracted by Krishna. This is the natural situation of everything in Vrindavan. Just contrary to the affairs of Vrindavan is the material world, where no one is attracted by Krishna and everyone is attracted by Maya. This is the difference between the spiritual and material worlds. Hiranyakasipu, who was in the material world, was attracted by women and money. Whereas Prahlad Maharaj, being in his natural position, was attracted by Krishna. In replying to Hiranyakasipu's question about why Prahlad Maharaj had a deviant view, Prahlad said that his view was not deviant, for the natural position of everyone is to be attracted by Krishna. Hiranyakasipu found this view deviant. Prahlad said, because of being unnaturally unattracted by Krishna, Hiranyakasipu therefore needed purification. As soon as one is purified by material contamination, he is again attracted by Krishna. Sarvopadhi vinirmuktam tat paratana nirmalam. In the material world, everyone is contaminated by the dirt of sense gratification and is acting according to different designations, sometimes as a human being, sometimes a beast, sometimes a demigod or a tree, and so on. One must be cleansed of all these designations. Then one will be naturally attracted to Krishna. The bhakti process purifies the living entity of all unnatural attractions. When one is purified, he is attracted by Krishna and begins to serve Krishna instead of serving Maya. This is his natural position. A devotee is attracted by Krishna, whereas a non-devotee, being contaminated by the dirt of material enjoyment, is not. This is confirmed by the Lord in the Bhagavad Gita. Yasaṁ tvantagataṁ pāpam janānaṁ puṇya karmaṇam te dvanda moha nirmukta bhajante maṁ drudhavratāḥ. Persons who have acted piously in previous lives and in this life, whose sinful actions are completely eradicated, and who are freed from the duality of delusion, engage themselves in my service with determination. One must be freed from all the sinful dirt of material existence. Everyone in this material world is contaminated by material desire. Unless one is free from all material desires, anya vilasita sunyam, one cannot be attracted by Krishna.
Om Jnanatimirandhasya Jnananjana Shalakaya Chakshur Unmilitam Yena Tasmai Sri Gurave Namah. Sri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Sthapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Svapadantikam. Vandeham Sri Guru Sri Tapada Kamalam Sri Gurun Vaishnavansa Sri Rupam Sagradatam Sagana Raghunatha Vitantam Sajivam సాద్వైతం సావధూతం పరిజన సహితం కృష్ణ చైతన్య దేవం శ్రీరాధాకృష్ణ పాదాన్ సగణలిత శ్రీ విశాఖాన్వితం హే కృష్ణ కరుణా సింధు దీనబంధు జగత్పతే గోపేశ గోపికా కంత రాధాకంత నమస్తే తప్త కంచన గౌరంగీ రాధే వృందావనేశ్వరీ విశ్వానసతే దేవి ప్రణమామి హరి ప్రియ వంశాకల్పతరువ్యశ్చ కృపాసింధువేవ చ పతితానాం పావనేభ్యో వైష్ణవేభ్యో నమః నమో మహావదన్నాయ కృష్ణ ప్రేమ ప్రదాయతే కృష్ణాయ కృష్ణ చైతన్య నమ్నే గౌరతిసే నమః జయ శ్రీకృష్ణ చైతన్య ప్రభు నిత్యానంద శ్రీ అద్వైత గదాధర్ శ్రీవాసాది గౌర భక్తవృంద హరే కృష్ణ 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 హరే 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 రామ 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 హరే 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 కృష్ణ 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 హరే 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 రామ 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 హరే 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 కృష్ణ 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 హరే 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 రామ రామ రామ
యథా భ్రమ్యతి అయో బ్రహ్మన్ స్వయం ఆకర్ష సన్నిధు తథా మే భిద్యతే చేతస్ చక్రపాణిర్ యదృచ్ఛయ. సో హియర్ ఇన్ దిస్ వర్స్ ప్రహ్లాద్ మహారాజ్ ఈజ్ ఎక్స్ప్రెసింగ్ his attraction towards the Supreme Personality of Godhead as natural. As it has been questioned by the teachers of Prahlad Maharaj, the so-called teachers of Prahlad Maharaj, Sandra and Amarka, who were great materialists, the sons of Shukracharya. So they had asked Prahlad Maharaj, who has polluted your mind or your intelligence? They were thinking surely enough Prahlad's intelligence was polluted by someone, because he was only a 5-year-old boy. So naturally, he would not be able to speak about devotional service to Lord Vishnu, which was unnatural in the part of the teachers. They were thinking, Prahlad, how he can say like this? That's why, so they asked Prahlad Maharaj, that mind your boy Prahlad, whatever you are speaking or whatever you spoke to your father, when your father asked you, what is the best thing you have learned from your teachers in your school? Then that time Prahlad Maharaj had answered that one should give up this Griha Andhakupa, the dark well of householder life, one should give this dark well of householder life and go to Vrindavan and cultivate Krishna consciousness. That is the goal of life. So when Prahlad Maharaj said this, Hiranyakasipu was surprised and his teachers were also surprised. So Hiranyakasipu pointed out to his teachers that certainly this boy should not have this type of knowledge. As a mere 5-year-old boy, how can he tell like this to perform devotional service to Lord Vishnu, who is our enemy? So Hiranyakasipu was considering Lord Vishnu as his greatest enemy. So Hiranyakasipu thought that someone has polluted the intelligence of this boy. So he cautioned the teachers that you find out that there must be some Vaishnavas who would be coming to your school in disguise and must be polluting this boy's intelligence. So you guard this. So when Sandana Amarka brought back Prahlad Maharaj to the school, so they asked Prahlad Maharaj, that mind, dear Prahlad, whatever you spoke to your father, the best thing you have learned in your school, we have not taught you this thing. And no one in your school, no other student, speak like this, what you spoke. Then where did you learn this thing? Who taught you this thing? We have not taught your teachers. We have not taught you. So who taught you these things? So Prahlad Maharaj, now he is answering the questions of Sandanda Amarka. So in previous verses, he has spoken about the friends and enemies, that how in this material world people are in bodily conception of life. They are thinking they are this body and everything belongs to this body is theirs. I and mine. Jivasya mohayam aham mameti. This is the greatest illusion in this material world. The living entity is thinking, I am this body and anything related to this body is mine. So this conception is a materialistic conception. So when someone thinks, oh, this person is helping me, helping in my enjoyment of this body, so he is my friend. This person is obstructing the enjoyment of my body, that's why he is my enemy. So in this material world, this conception of friend and enemy is coming from this bodily conception of life. So Prahlad Maharaj said that this is the illusory energy of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who is actually bewildering the living entities of this material world. Being bewildered by the external energy of the Lord, the living entities, though they are part and parcel of Krishna, but they are thinking they are this material body and anything belongs to this material body is theirs. That's why they develop this conception of friendship and enmity. And now Prahlad Maharaj is answering in this verse how his intelligence is actually not polluted. His intelligence is pure. That's why he is naturally attracted to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna, whose intelligence is polluted. He will never be attracted towards the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. So we see in this material world, because people have material conceptions, bodily conceptions, that's why they always want to enjoy. That's why they are always thinking about their sense objects. And in that way, they are not attracted towards Krishna. They are attracted towards the sense objects, sense gratification. Because their intelligence has been polluted by Maya. Whereas those who are in spiritual world or in spiritual consciousness, free from this bodily consciousness, because their intelligence is pure, that's why they are naturally attracted towards Krishna. So in the purport of this verse, Srila Prabhupada gives the example of the inhabitants of Vrindavan. That how the inhabitants of Vrindavan are naturally attracted towards Krishna. Whereas the inhabitants of this material world are not naturally attracted towards Krishna. So Prabhupada says that the inhabitants of Vrindavan, such as Nanda Maharaj, Mother Yashoda, they are naturally attracted towards Krishna. In a loving relationship, paternal relationship. So they think Krishna as their son. Even if sometimes Krishna shows his opulence, like Krishna showed his opulence to Mother Yashoda, showed the Brahmanda, showed the universe within his mouth. But Mother Yashoda was not affected by that. She thought that Krishna is nothing else but his son. Whereas when Devaki and Vasudev saw the Vishnu form of Krishna, so they thought Krishna was God. So as soon as Krishna and Balaram, they killed Kansa and then went to meet their parents, so they were expecting that Vasudev and Devaki would come forward and embrace them as their sons, because they are meeting with them after long, long years. But Devaki and Vasudev were captivated by the opulence of Krishna. And that's why they are standing in folded hands, thinking Krishna as the Supreme Personality of Godhead. So their paternal affection and maternal affection did not arise within their heart. And when Krishna saw this, then immediately Krishna employed his yogamaya potence. And then they forgot about the opulence of Krishna. Then only paternal and maternal thoughts arise within their hearts. So the inhabitants of Vrindavan are naturally attracted towards Krishna. Even if Krishna shows his opulence, as the supreme personality of Godhead. But the Brajavasis never attracted to Krishna's opulence. They think Krishna as theirs, their own family members. Krishna belongs to them. That's why the Brajavasis, the inhabitants of Vrindavan, even they loved Krishna more than their own children. Naturally, the parents would love their children the most. But the inhabitants of Vrindavan, they loved Krishna more than their own children. That was the natural attraction flowing in the hearts of the Brajavasis. And not only the elderly people, even the friends of Krishna, they were also naturally attracted towards Krishna. The gopis, Srimati Radharani, they were naturally attracted towards Krishna. And not only human beings, even the animals, the cows, the calves, the beasts in the jungle, even the trees, the flowers and fruits, everyone was attracted towards Krishna. Because everyone was in pure consciousness, Krishna consciousness, pure intelligence. Their intelligence was not polluted by anything. That's why this attraction for Krishna was natural for them. Because the living entities are naturally part and parcel of Krishna, so there should be a natural attraction. But when the living entities, they want to enjoy apart from Krishna, this enjoying propensity to enjoy apart from Krishna is actually polluting this mind. That's why in this material world, we see that because people have this propensity to enjoy sense gratification, that's why they are never attracted towards Krishna. Hiranyakasipu was a unique example of a great materialist. His very name, Hiranyakasipu. Hiranya means gold. Kasipu means bed. So materialistic people, they want mostly these two things. They want wealth, money, and they want women to enjoy. So this is the goal of their life. So Hiranyakasipu, he was very opulent material. He was actually ruling over the entire universe, the three worlds, even the demigods were actually serving Hiranyakasipu. Except Lord Brahma, Shiva and Vishnu. Other demigods were serving Hiranyakasipu. He was so powerful. And he was very good in sense enjoyment. That's why he was never attracted towards Krishna, and he was thinking Krishna as his enemy. So here we see that Prahlad Maharaj says that, my dear Brahmanas, yatha brahmati ayo brahman swayam akarsa sannidho. So Prahlad Maharaj gives an example that the iron is naturally attracted towards the magnet. When there is a magnet and nearby there is iron, it will naturally be attracted towards the magnet. And it will go towards the magnet, natural. So in the same way, tatha me vidyate chetas chakrapane yadruchaya. So here, this example is very appropriate. That if the iron piece is pure iron, it will be attracted towards the magnet. But if the iron piece is covered by junk items, so it may not be attracted towards the magnet. So in the same way, when the consciousness is pure, it will naturally be attracted towards Krishna. And when the consciousness is impure or covered by the desire of sense gratification, it will never be attracted towards Krishna. So that's why Prahlad Maharaj says that as the iron is naturally attracted towards the magnet, in the same way, my consciousness is attracted towards Lord Chakrapani. And here, Prahlad Maharaj is using the word yadruchaya. Means, by the will of Krishna. This was the will of Krishna that Prahlad Maharaj's consciousness was attracted towards him because he was a great devotee of Lord Krishna. So, Lord Krishna, he is Bhakta Vatsal. The devotees are very dear to the Lord. So the Supreme Lord, out of affection for his devotees, he attracts the consciousness of the devotees towards him. This is actually the mercy of the Lord. So when one receives the mercy of the Lord, his consciousness will be always be attracted towards the lotus feet of Krishna. And as Prahlad Maharaj was a Mahabhagavata, a great devotee, pure devotee of the Lord, his attraction towards the Supreme Lord Krishna was natural. And as we also know, the other day we were also discussing, Prahlad Maharaj was a doorkeeper of Vaikuntha in his previous life. So, he was naturally attracted, he was Krishna's great devotee, naturally attracted towards Krishna. So there was nothing unnatural for him. Whereas, the teachers were thinking it was unnatural for Prahlad Maharaj to be attracted towards Krishna. That's why they were thinking his consciousness was polluted. But here Prahlad Maharaj says that this attraction is by the will of Krishna. I am naturally attracted, like the iron is attracted towards the magnet. I am my consciousness, my intelligence is attracted naturally to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. Here he uses the word Chakrapani. The Lord who is holding a disc. So here the Lord holds the disc, and what is the function of the disc? He cuts the knots of this material bondage of the living entity. विद्यते हृदय ग्रंथि छिद्यन्ते सर्व संशय. सो देर इज ए नट विद इन दिस हार्ट, हृदय ग्रंथि, एंड दिस नट इज देयर फॉर मेटेरियल सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेशन. सो व्हेन दिस कॉन्शियसनेस इज पॉल्यूटेड, दिस नट बिकम्स वेरी स्ट्रांग एंड वन डिजायर्स दिस मेटेरियल सेंस ग्रेटिफिकेशन, एंड दिस हैज टू बी कट इनटू पीसेस. That said, the Lord uses his disc by his own mercy. Out of his mercy, he cuts the knot of material wonders of the living entity and purifies the heart. Then, when one's heart is purified, then one will be naturally attracted towards Krishna. So, Lord Krishna, by his own will, yadruchaya. So when Krishna wants, brahmanda brahmite kona, bhagyavana jiva, guru Krishna, prasada paya, bhakti lata. So after wandering in unlimited universes, by the mercy of guru and Krishna, one gets the seed of bhakti lata, the seed of devotion. And by performing devotional service, one will be purified. His heart will be purified. His consciousness will be purified. Then he will be attracted towards Krishna. So this is by the mercy of Guru and Krishna. So here, we see that Prahlad Maharaj says that this Chakrapani, the holder of the disc, Lord Krishna has changed my consciousness. That's why my consciousness is naturally attracted towards him. This is my position. That's why I have no independence. Prahlad Maharaj said that I cannot do anything about it. You are all telling that my consciousness is polluted, but what can I do? I cannot do anything about it. It is naturally attracted towards Krishna by the will of Krishna. So it has been actually stated, this is the state of a pure devotee of the Lord. Those who are Mahabhagavatas, their consciousness is naturally attracted towards Krishna. So their consciousness is never polluted. So their consciousness is purified consciousness. Actually, the consciousness of the materialistic people is polluted. So their consciousness has to be purified. Then only they can develop this natural attachment or attraction for Krishna. So sometimes we see that people, when they see someone is becoming little attached to Krishna, are attached to devotional service of Krishna by the association of devotees. Because this devotee association is very contaminating. It can change the heart of the people. That's why the materialistic people think, oh, this person is associating with the devotees, that's why his consciousness has been contaminated. So he has, they use the word brainwashing. So they said they have brainwashed this person, changed this consciousness of this person. So actually, all these materialistic people's consciousness has to be washed. Their consciousness is actually polluted because of their desire for sense gratification. So they all need brainwashing. So those who are pure devotees of the Lord, actually whose consciousness has been purified by performing devotional service, so their consciousness is naturally attracted when they hear about the glories of the Lord. Madguna suti matrena mai sarva guhasa. As soon as a devotee hears my attributes, my glories, then me, who is sitting within the heart of all living entities, sarva guhasa, who is sitting in the heart of all living entities. So when a devotee hears about my glories, then what happens? Mano gatir avichinna. So his mano gati, the movement of his mind or heart, that moves avichinna without interruption. Towards whom? The mind moves towards Krishna without any interruption. Then the example is given, Ganga vaso ambudho. Like the water of the Ganges moves towards the ocean without any interruption. In the same way, the consciousness of the devotee moves towards Krishna without any interruption. That is the pure consciousness of a pure devotee. When our consciousness is interrupted, like we are thinking of Krishna, then something happens. Then we look towards that or think about that. Then our conscious thinking of Krishna is interrupted. That means our consciousness is not pure. If it is being interrupted by something else, that means our consciousness is not pure. So the consciousness of a pure devotee is uninterrupted. Doesn't matter what happens, but he will go on thinking about Krishna. Go on thinking about Krishna's glories, his pastimes, his form. Like we see in the case of Prahlad Maharaj. Prahlad Maharaj was attacked by Hiranyakashipu's followers. They wanted to kill him in so many ways. And naturally, when there is a fear of death, then naturally anyone can become fearful. Because we all want to save our body. That's why we are afraid of death. We are fearful of death. So in that state, naturally one will be very, very disturbed. If death is in front of somebody, how one can be in a peaceful situation in that state? Nobody can be in peaceful situation. But in Prahlad Maharaj's case, though death was surrounding him from all sides, but Prahlad Maharaj was undisturbed. He was very peaceful. He was never in anxiety. And he was only thinking about the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Krishna. Without any interruption. That is the way a pure devotee behaves. His consciousness constantly moves towards Krishna. He always thinks of Krishna. Doesn't matter what happens. He does not become disturbed. That is the situation of a pure devotee. And that is called Nirguna Bhakti Yoga. This pure devotional service, which is free from these material modes. And in this situation, one will be always united with Krishna. But those who are not performing pure devotional service, then their devotional service will be interrupted in so many ways. That's why Lord Kapil Dev, while describing about devotional service, he is describing four types of devotional service in four modes. Devotional service in the mode of ignorance, devotional service in the mode of passion, devotional service in the mode of goodness, and devotional service in the mode of Nirguna, free from all these three modes, pure devotional service. So this is the example of pure devotional service. When one's consciousness is uninterrupted, is thinking about Krishna all the time without any obstruction. But those who are performing devotional service, but their consciousness is interrupted in so many ways. They are affected by the three modes of material nature. So Lord Kapil Dev says that those who are performing devotional service in the mode of ignorance, what is the symptom of this devotees? Because we see in our Krishna consciousness movement, we have so many devotees. Devotees are increasing day by day. And we are very proud that, we are Krishna's devotees. But we are what type of devotees, we should know. What is our consciousness? Accordingly, we will be classified whether we are a tamasa bhakta, a devotee in the mode of ignorance, a devotee in the mode of passion, a devotee in the mode of goodness, or a devotee in the mode of pure goodness. In which state we are, we can check ourselves and also know others. So Lord Kapil Dev says, Abhisandhaya jo hinsang dambam ascharjam evava. Saram bhi vinna drugbhava mayi kuryat sa tamasa. So those who are performing devotional service, but they are always aiming for violence. They are very violent in character. They are performing some devotional service, but they are very violent in their attitude towards other living entities. And they are very proud of their position. They think they are the best devotee. Very proud of their position. And then they are very envious of others. When other devotees make advancement, then they become very envious of you. They try to criticize. that other devotee and make offenses. And then they are very angry, very revengeful. Sometimes something happens to them, they want to take a revenge upon the other devotee. They are very revengeful, become very angry. So this type of devotees, we have to understand they are in the mood of tamasa, ignorance. And it has been stated in Skanda Purana that if this type of devotees do not correct themselves, do not give up this attitude, and in that state they leave their body, in next life they will go to Pitrulok. Pitrulok is next to Narkalok, where Yamaraj resides. Pitrulok. So then he describes what Kapil Dev describes about the devotees in the mode of passion. So those devotees, Vishayan Avisandhaya Yasa Aishwarya Evava. So those devotees always aiming for sense gratification. They are performing devotional service, but they are always thinking of sense gratification also, side by side. They also want name and fame. That's why they always make arrangements how their glories will be spread all over the world. So these devotees, they want material opulence, they want material riches, and they want to become very famous. So famous as a devotee or famous as a good speaker or famous as a good pujari or whatever, they all want to become very famous. So this attitude is there. So then if they worship the deity with this type of mentality, so then archado archayadiyomang prithak bhava sa rajasa. So this type of devotees are to be considered in the mode of passion, rajas devotee. And they are here called separatists. Lord Kapil Dev uses the word prithak bhava. Prithak bhava means they are not one with the Supreme Lord. One with the Supreme Lord means they are not one in interest with the Supreme Lord. They have a separate interest. That's why they are called separatists. They have prithak bhava. The Lord wants something, these devotees want something else, separate from the Lord. That's why they are called separatists. So these devotees are in the mode of passion, tamas devotees. And then there are another kind of devotees, karma niharam uddishya parasmin va tad arpana yajed yastavyam iti va prithak bhavam sa sattika. And devotees, those who are in the mode of goodness, what is their symptom? They perform fruitive activity in varnasram system, for varnas and for ashramas. They perform their duties, fruitive activities according to varna and according to their ashram. And then, while performing the fruitive activities, there will be inebrieties, faults in performing those activities. That's why what they do, they offer the results of their activities to the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is called karmarpana. The fruits of the activity is offered to Krishna. So these devotees, when they offer the fruits of their activities with the mood to become free from the inebrieties of these fruitive reactions, these devotees are called in the mode of goodness. So, but if a devotee is performing activity and he offers everything for the satisfaction of Krishna, then only he can perform pure devotional service. But if someone offers the result of activity to become free from the inebrieties or faults, then he is in the mode of goodness. So one has to come to the platform of pure goodness. That is pure devotional service. So those who are performing devotional service in the mode of passion and they leave their body in that state, their next life is swarga. They will get a heavenly planet. Those who want opulence, material opulence, those who want fame, and those who want sense gratification, and they perform devotional service for that. So their next life is heavenly planet. Those who perform devotional service in the mode of goodness, if they leave their body in that state, then their next life will be in Brahma Loka. They will go to Brahma's planet. But those who perform pure devotional service, their next life will be Krishna Loka. They can only go back to Krishna. So our goal is to perform pure devotional service like Prahlad Maharaj performed. And here Prahlad Maharaj is exhibiting the symptoms of a pure devotee, Mahabhagavata. That's why he is telling to his teachers that his consciousness was not polluted. Actually, Hiranyakasipu's consciousness was polluted. His teacher's consciousness was polluted. That's why they are thinking Lord Vishnu as their enemy. Whereas, every living entity is part and parcel of Krishna, and in pure state, he is naturally to be attracted towards Krishna. So Prahlad Maharaj is only doing that. His natural relationship with Krishna, he is exhibiting. So his consciousness was never polluted and will never be polluted. Though in the eyes of Hiranyakasipu and the teachers, Prahlad Maharaj's consciousness was polluted because of their materialistic view. Actually, their consciousness was polluted. So in this way, Prahlad Maharaj is actually establishing his supreme position as a pure devotee of Krishna from the symptoms he is exhibiting. Hare Krishna. So I think it's already late. Jai Grantara Srimad Bhagavatam Ki. जय श्री श्री गौरनिताय की जय श्री श्री कृष्ण बलराम की जय Sister Radha San Sundaral Tavisagadevi ki jai. Srila Prabhupada Maharaj ki jai. Gaurav Bhakta Vrinda ki jai. Nitai Gaur Premanande Hari.